Welcome back to the shed. This is the latest little project I have been working on, and this was given to me as a birthday present from my family last April, and I've been working on it on and off for about the last 6 months, but have now finally got it finished and up and running. It's a 1/8 scale model of a steam drilling engine, which is produced by a company called PM Research Model Engines, based in Wellsville, New York. Although you can buy these models from various outlets in other parts of the world, mine being bought from a UK supplier, Forest Classics. The engine is double acting with slide valve and has a 1-inch cylinder bore and a 1.5-inch stroke, and has a nicely proportioned 6.5-inch spoked flywheel, and the overall length of the engine is about 12 inches. This style of engine would typically have been used to power the drilling derricks, which were a commonplace sight across the oil fields of New York and Pennsylvania throughout the latter half of the 19th century, after the discovery of oil there in 1859, and would have been around 9 or 10 horsepower, and a similar size to this Jessop and Appleby engine, which I saw at the Fawnsett Steam Museum in Norfolk in the UK. The PM Research engine comes as a cast iron and bronze raw casting kit and needs to be machined before assembly. Several jigs and fixtures need to be made to enable the raw castings to be held securely for machining. This one for holding the conrod and machining the slide gliders, and it was also used to set the dimensions of a fly cutter for machining the chassis to suit the cylinder. This jig was designed to hold the crankshaft in the lathe to turn the offset crank journal. To help with the work holding of the main chassis, I bought this adjustable angle plate and used a fixture plate to attach the chassis to. This allowed milling operations at horizontal, vertical and 45 degrees as required, without the need for constantly changing the work holding setup. The engine was made in my workshop using a lathe, milling machine and a pillar drill, and is the first time I've built an engine from raw castings, and I can certainly say that it was a fun process and quite a challenge at the same time. There are two very helpful video series on YouTube about this engine build, by Joe Pyszynski from Advanced Innovations and Quinn Dunkey from Blondie Hacks, both of which have been very helpful during this engine build. I added this nice little microcosm flyball governor and set it to restrict the maximum engine speed, and turned a 40mm pulley which drives the governor at approximately a 4:1 ratio. This gives enough speed to allow the governor to be fully functional. The belting was made from some 2mm polyurethane belt, which is cut to size and then joined using a hot blade. I wasn't too keen on the green colour, so this was simply recoloured with a black Sharpie. The governor has this bevel gearing set for drive, but I opted to use a direct drive horizontally on the shaft. but the governor looked kind of naked without them, so I turned a mini brass flywheel and left them in place, as they look nice even if they are non-functional. I made one or two modifications to the original drawings and decided to use a pair of oil light bearing bushes. These are simply clamps between the bearing caps, and small brass spacers are used to space the flywheel and eccentric. The miniature oilers are a really nice feature, if not a little bit fiddly to make, and although not really needed with the oil light bushings, I still drilled a hole through the bushes to line up with the oilers so that extra lubrication can be added. The main piston shaft and the eccentric driven valve rod were both swapped out for 3 and 5mm metric silver steel, as I don't own any imperial reamers for when making the stuffing glands. The cylinder has this bronze inboard head, so I decided to make an additional brass ring for the front cylinder cover to give it some symmetry, and it looks nice against the cream coloured paint. The governor was piped up to the steam chest using 1/8 inch copper pipe and 1/4-40 pipe unions. My pipe bends aren't perfect, but this was my third attempt after messing up the previous two, so it'll have to do for now. The kit was supplied with these cheesehead type imperial machine screws, but once again I don't own the correct taps for these threads, so these were all changed to M2 and M3 hex headed fixings, which I also felt looked more natural on the engine. So, if anyone out there needs a bolt set for this engine, just give me a shout, as I have one going spare. Also supplied was this PTFE gland packing material, but I decided to use my normal graphited yarn that I know and trust. Now, before I get lots of comments telling me that my flywheel has a wobble, this really was a difficult casting to get any kind of resemblance of trueness, as the inner spoke rim seemed to be offset slightly, as though the two halves of the pattern had slipped out of alignment whilst being cast. Or at least, that's the excuse I'm sticking with. It was a particularly difficult casting to machine perfectly true. I built this simple tapered edge plywood box as a base, but I'm no woodworker, so if there's anyone out there in YouTube land who can make me something nicer, please get in touch. So there you go, about 6 months in the making, lots of head scratching and some minor metrification design changes from the original drawings. But I now have a very lovely looking engine finished on my workbench. My next task is to get it hooked up to my pressure cooker boiler, as I'm sure this lovely engine will run even sweeter on steam. Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching.